Fra Angelico's Christ Glorified shows us angels as messengers, and that's the essential meaning of what an angel is. The angels in this painting are almost like humans, except they're perfect humans, and they have wings scattered with bits of gold in very, very bright colours. They're on the cusp between the human and the divine. The angels are here as witnesses to Christ's resurrection, and they also will spread the news from the world of the divine to the world of humanity.
One of the things that we heavily associate angels with is announcing good news, and that's one of the things that's happening in this really small picture by Sint Jans, which is called Nativity at Night. Up in the sky, there is a phosphorescent little figure announcing to the shepherds on the distant hillside that a child has been born that they must go and visit.
What's extraordinary is the way in which the angel is made up of this silvery, ethereal light, almost like moonlight, which is so much stronger than the little light that the shepherds have made burning their fire on the hillside.
After Henry VIII's Reformation, any Catholic imagery is of course banned. So angels, which we associate with big Roman Catholic altarpieces, don't appear. That's why the angel in this picture, painted by Sir Anthony van Dyck, was misidentified as Cupid. It's a marriage portrait that was commissioned to celebrate the marriage of Dorothy Thimbleby, so you would expect Cupid, the god of love, to be there, but it's not Cupid. It's an angel. It's a messenger angel, the attribute of Dorothy's name saint, Saint Dorothy. She sent this angel with the flowers from heaven when she'd been martyred as a gift to her executioner. The Thimblebys were a Catholic family, their wedding was celebrated by a Catholic priest, and it got them into all kinds of trouble.
I can't think of a role as the messenger more important than that conveyed by Gabriel. He brings the message to Mary that she is going to bear the Son of God. Gabriel bows to Mary as if she's a queen, but yet she's a normal girl represented in her bedchamber. So he conveys her divinity, which is not represented at all, by his gestures and by his attitude. You might also notice his extraordinary peacock-coloured wings, which are just magnificent and a thing of great beauty.